I want everyone just to, for a minute, just if you could go back maybe 2,500 years back in the Old Testament. You know, back at that time, the ones that need you to go ahead and get ready, youth, let's go ahead and get ready. Back in the 2,500 years ago, if you could go back in the Old Testament, you know, things were a lot different than it was nowadays. You know, back then they had to sacrifice. They had to do these things to receive forgiveness of sin. And they looked for the hope of a Messiah. They looked for the hope of one that would come, that would pay the penalty for sin forever. They looked for that one that would come. And that day didn't come. That day didn't come. You know, much of Israel, they didn't know that day when it did come. But there were some that did know. And you know, here
in Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, it says, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel," which being interpreted is God with us. Praise the Lord. Amen. And that Christmas night, Jesus came and he fulfilled so many different prophecies by becoming the Messiah, the Savior of the world. And there he was. He came into this world. And in my mind's eye, I see all of these different miracles that happened through the life of Jesus Christ. I see as he raises a sick one up from their bed. I see as he raises up maybe a person from the dead. So many were healed and touched by his life on earth. And sometimes I can almost get jealous of those times. Because wow, what it would be like to walk with Jesus Christ as he was here on earth. So much things that he did. So many things I could learn and know. You know, we get to read the Bible and we get to hear all these different wonderful stories. But what if you could actually go back to those times and experience that? God with us. God with us. Praise the Lord. But you know, I begin to think, Jesus Christ came, he lived, he died for you and he died for me. And this is something that is so different that those didn't get to experience. They got to see Jesus Christ with them. It was God with us. But here in this generation, in this last hour, I believe this is the end times. At this time, it is now God in us. Not just God with us. Praise the Lord. The youth has been working really hard, learning their parts, practicing. And you know, the title is called A Thrill of Hope. The Thrill of Hope. And you know, we get to experience that hope. The ones that waited so many years for the Messiah to come. The ones that got to walk with them, with Jesus Christ, as he was here on earth. What a wonderful thing. But here it is. Jesus Christ can be in us. Not just Emmanuel, God with us, but God in us. The thrill of hope. We're so glad for each and every one of you here tonight. Amen. There's this, the story is of three different families. One lost a family member. One with a broken home. Another, the family members out to war. And all of these get to come together. We're so excited for you guys to see this. And we'll go ahead and get started here soon. If someone could get the light.
Or a quiet house? What if this Christmas didn't turn out Why might you have pictured it? What would it mean to you then? Would it really be worth celebrating at all?
Sorry, Mrs. Parker. I know this isn't the news you wanted to hear, but there's nothing else we can do.
Oh, Greg. It's been nearly a year. Yet sometimes I can't believe you're really gone. I don't know how we're ever going to get through this Christmas without you.
Has anyone seen my phone? No, that information machine. I can never find it when I need it. And it really was a smart coffee stock. We lost it.
Sure.
Okay, guys, are you ready? I've been practicing all week. I'm so excited. I'm ready for this. This is so great. They're going to fly.
Thank you. glad you visited. Glad you visited.
Well, I think everything just got ready. Just round up the kids and get started.
I'll go see if I can find you. I'm not back in 5 minutes. Probably not going to have a snowball or something.
All the food is ready except the pies. Granny, I thought you were making those. Are they ready? Granny!
Granny! They're being delivered!
What? Granny, what'd she say?
I said they're being delivered! Everybody, watch. Kill it, I got yourself for Christmas. It's just a glue stick.
Man, glad to see you, son.
Well, you done it again, Lord. I was afraid they weren't going to listen to me. But they did, and people get so hung up in their stockings at Christmas that they forget that they have a reason to celebrate. Even the people that are hurting, and there's so many, Lord, they have a reason to rejoice. I don't know how to get the message to them, but you do. And I know you're the Lord. You always do. Save me a piece of baby pie!
In John chapter 10, verse 10, it says, "The thief cometh not, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy." This is what Jesus says. If you got a Bible that says words in red, it's Jesus' words. This is what Jesus says. He simply says this, the reason. He says, "I am come that ye might have life." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And you know, in each one of those situations, they had a reason to celebrate because the I Am came. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's all stand. Sister Marie, would you go to the please and help us out. Praise the Lord. Amen. The I Am came. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, I don't know what situation every person came in here tonight. Praise the Lord. Amen. But Jesus Christ has come. He's come for me. He's come for you. Maybe the situation that you came in is you have a family that's a member that's broken. You know, maybe they ended up passing away. I mean, maybe it was a grandfather, a grandmother. Maybe it was a father. Maybe it was a mother. Maybe it was a brother, a sister, a daughter, a son. You come in and your heart's hurting tonight. You're saying, how can I have Christmas this year? This year is so hard for me. Maybe you're the one that the parent has walked out. Your spouse has walked out. Your dad has walked out. Your mother has walked out. And you said, how can I have Christmas this year? How can I have Christmas this year? I can relate to that. Amen. It's been 8 years since my father walked out. Sometimes you can say, how can I have Christmas this year? You can. Because he came. Praise the Lord. Amen. Tonight, let's all bow our heads. So you can have a reason to partake of that blessed hope. Amen. Of the Messiah that came. Amen. Amen. He came for each and every family here. Each and every individual here. Jesus Christ came. Why did he come? He said, I came that ye might have life and have it more abundantly. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ tonight came for you. Amen. And he's extending that life to you tonight. Praise the Lord. He loves you. That's why he came. He came for you. You know, there's funny times that we saw. But the fact of the matter is, the ones that were going through it, you know, they laughed maybe on the outside, but on the inside they were crying. Maybe they were hurting. And that's you tonight. You come and you're hurting. You're saying, Jesus, I need you. I need your life. That's you tonight. I want to extend the opportunity for you to come to this altar and find a place to ask the Lord to come into your life and to give you true life, true joy, true happiness. Amen. to this place tonight for you. He loves you, and He wants to come inside. He wants to be your Lord and your King, and to give you peace and joy like you've never known before. And He can do that tonight. I can promise you that. Because in the recent past, when my father walked out on my family, I found peace, true peace. I found joy, true joy. Amen. It was unspeakable. I couldn't explain it. I can't explain it now, but I can tell you in the hard times of my life, I looked to Jesus Christ, and He gave me life. Amen. Tonight, and you feel the Lord drawing you. You feel the Lord prompting you, tugging on your heart. Amen. That this is something that you should do. You need to come and invite Him into your life. Would you raise your hand and say, Gabe, Brother Gabe, that's me. Amen. I need Jesus Christ in my life tonight. Amen. He'll come for you. Thank you. Thank you. Would there be another? Amen. Jesus Christ has come to give you true peace and true joy, just like He gave me and so many others that's in this room tonight. Amen. Would there be another? Praise the Lord. Amen. True joy. Amen. Life. Praise the Lord. The ones that raised their hand, would you come? Let's find a place to pray. Amen. You raise your hand. Let's find a place to pray here tonight. Amen. You will have many loving brothers and sisters that will pray for you. They'll put their arm around you. Amen. Would there be another? Would there be another? Brothers, let's be by ourselves.